Hey you, what's up? I'm Angelos and today I'd like to share you one very very aggressive weapon with black, and this weapon called Martial Attack is the only system that we call it attack as black, because black is really really attacking. Now we can see a position from the game Kramnik against Leko. This is from the World Championship match played in 2004. This match tied and Kramnik managed to keep his title, but this game was really really interesting, and Leko managed to trick Kramnik, his computer and his analytical team. He found a better plan here. Can you do the same in order to fight for the world champion? It's black's turn. So let's see the game from the scratch. C4, E5, Knight F3, Knight C6, Bishop B5, the Spanish, A6, Bishop A4, no Berlin today, Knight F6, sword castling, Bishop E7, Rook E1, B5, all these moves are very well known in the theory, Bishop B3, sword castling, and now if you like to avoid Marshall, then you can play the move A4 or D3. These are solid and very logical options. However, here white played C3 and invite Leko to play the Marshall Gambit. So D5, E takes D5, Knight takes D5, Knight takes E5, Knight takes E5, Rook takes E5, our knight on D5 is under attack, so C6, D4 and Bishop D6. You can see now, after this move, Rook E1, how aggressive the black pieces are. Everything are looking here against the king side, so black will have the attack, and this is why we call it Martial Attack. This is a system that Marshall prepared for 10 years, he kept it secret, and he played it for first time against Capablanca. But Capablanca was really really good and very strong person, and in the board he managed to refute this Marshall attack and win this first game. But he didn't harm the reputation, because Marshall is a very reliable weapon, you can use it. So after that, queen h4, we are threatening a check, a deadly check on h2. So g3 in order to protect this, queen h3s, and as you can see, we can transfer the bishop here on g4, on f3, we can deliver a checkmate. Everything looks natural here for black, and rook e4. This move start becoming annoying, because white would like to play here with a rook h4 and annoy the queen. He stopped this move, bishop to g4, and in 1999, Petrosian against Averbakh come here with a brilliant move, g5. Let's see that game. What happened there? First of all, let's see this one, the very obvious. What will happen if white captured g5? It's your turn. What are you going to do now? And of course, we will going to give this double attack. We are attacking the rook and the bishop, so we will win material. And in this game, Petrosian played another normal move, knight to d2. What to do? Bishop f5. We are attacking the rook. Queen e2. Very, very often, white sacrifice material in order to stop or refute black's attack. And black is not interesting to capture material, to collect material. He would like to attack. Yes, we would like to attack. Rook e5 in order to sacrifice the rook in any case. And after that, we capture here. Bishop takes e5, d takes e5, knight g4. Again, we are creating this very nice threat. Queen takes h2 and queen h1 checkmate, right? It's nice to create checkmate threats, isn't it? Knight f3 and now rook ae8. We bring all of our pieces in the game, and you can feel the pressure, right? White is a pawn up, but his pieces are undeveloped. So if you don't know what to do, this is something strange. So Petrosian here didn't play the best move. He felt this pressure, and for that reason he tried to exchange queens, and this was a very bad mistake. Queen takes f1, king takes f1 and h6 in order to protect the kingside pawns. As you can see, everything is rock solid. h4 in order to open some lines, bishop e4, he would like to remove the defender, and after that he will capture the pawn back. Knight e1, rook takes e5 and now f4, and I am providing this game for this particular moment. What are you going to do here with black? It's black's turn. And he found a brilliant move. g takes h4. What is the idea? If our opponent captures the rook, then we can play h3 and no one can stop this powerful pawn. We will have a new queen. So let's go back to our game. And here after rook e4, we have g5. This is how this move developed. And Kramnik here prepared, of course, the queen f1, this move. He would like to exchange queens and everything looks natural, right? So, queen f5, knight d2, bishop f5, f3. Again, white would like to sacrifice the rook in order to stop black's attack. And black are not interesting about that. He played knight f6, of course, rook e1, rook ae8, a typical move. In order to fight for the A-line, rook takes c8, rook takes c8, a4. And now we have this position. Did you manage to find the plan? He played the move queen g6. What is the idea? The idea is to prevail, to control the light squares. And after this exchange, this is very normal because white would like to open the rook and find some counterplay, right? He played this move, bishop d3. Queen f2, everything looks normal, right? And after this move, rook e2, Kramnik had prepared this move, queen takes e2, and bishop takes e2, and now it seems that after this, a takes b6, white have amazing game. Why? This pawn gives tremendous initiative to white. He would like to push it forward and create a new queen, right? And if we capture this pawn with a bishop, then the rook can recapture the bishop and we have a lot of material. Where is the attack? We cannot attack. And Leko tricked here Kramnik because he was better prepared and he found this amazing move, queen d3. Whoa, now we are threatening a lot of nasty things against the enemy king. King f2, what else to play? And now he played another very nice move. It is a tactic. In order to help you a little more, the rook on a1 is unprotected and we have all of our pieces ready here against the enemy king, so we should have something. The only defender is the knight, right? So we should do something. Can you find it? It's very difficult, of course. Bishop takes f3, knight takes f3, and after that we deliver a check on e4. Now the king doesn't have a lot of options. For example, if he goes here on g2, then we can give this check, king h3, queen takes f3, and you can see that how to stop this checkmate, this brilliant checkmate on f2, right? The king don't have good squares. This is one variation. Another variation is to go on g1, but after that we can capture the knight and we can deliver this checkmate on f2 and then on f1. So the other move is to go here, and black here have something more. He's not interesting only to capture the knight, but he captured here on c3. He is threatening checkmate on e2, b takes c3, and the double attack. King f2 and queen capture on a1. Black have winning position here, and after a7 we are not in hurry. We solidly protect our pawns, and after that we will collect this unprotected far advanced pawn on a7. He tried h4, but after g4 all dreams come over, and Leko managed to win a brilliant game. So let's move forward and see some of my games. The next year, 2005, I played the game against Papagiorgiou in my local city, Ioannina, and here white didn't play this move c3, he tried to avoid the marshal and he played a4. Okay, everything is natural. So, bishop b7, we are preparing our pieces, he played c3, and this is a mistake. Why this is a mistake? Because we leave d3 pawn square unprotected. So, d5. E takes d5, knight takes d5, knight takes e5, knight takes e5, rook takes e5, and now knight f4. Black is threatening to go here with a knight or with a queen in order to stop white's development, and if black manages to do something about this square, white will have huge difficulties here. For that reason, he played d4, and after that, I capture on g2. A takes b5, a takes b5, rook takes a8, bishop takes a8, and queen g4. We don't give material, the material is equal, and the white's king side is totally destroyed, right? Because we capture something on g2 and the king shield is not very well protected. Now it's black's turn. I played this move, knight to h4, and I'm creating this threat, knight f3, in order to attack the king and the rook. He played rook h5, what to do? He would like to create some counter-attacking chances here on my king. Can you spot the right move for black? It's black's turn and winning. Bishop f3, congratulations, you're securing the queen and the rook is unprotected. White cannot do anything and he loses the game instantly in 17 moves. But don't go away, I have another game for you. Here we have the same position. I played with another person here, Benaches. It is in 2006, and this player played against this move a4, bishop b7, c3, and the same mistake. d5, e takes d5, knight takes d5, and now he didn't capture on e5, but he prefers to develop his pieces with d4. Unfortunately for white, black have a very good development, and if you try to open the position right now, you are helping only the black pieces. E takes d4, knight takes d4, knight takes d4, queen takes d4, bishop d6, and again you can see how aggressively placed these pieces are. It is fantastic. All of black pieces are very good placed, and we are ready to start the attack against the enemy kingside. Knight d2 in order to develop one piece, c5 and queen g4. Now you should find a plan for black. Can't you find a good plan for black? It's black's turn. I'm very, very happy for my move. It's not the first computer move, but I played here h5. A very nice pawn sacrifice. And what is the idea? It's temporarily sacrificed because after this, queen takes h5, we have this, the same motif, the same pattern, you know, knight f4, and we are attacking the queen on h5 and g2. After queen g4, I capture here on g2, and after rook d1, I don't really afraid anything on the d line because the d line is closed for now. Queen h4, I exchange queens, and I'm threatening here to capture on h2, and black have amazing development, so I feel very nice here to exchange queens, and I can continue my attack slowly. So queen takes h4, knight takes h4, c4, another mistake because white would like to open the position, not close it, and of course I close the position with b4, bishop c2, rook d8 in order to solidly protect everything, rook e1, and we have now the very typical martial move, rook e1. We would like to fight in the line. So rook takes e8, rook takes e8, and we are threatening this deadly check here on e1. So he played f3, and after that rook e2. We are creating a new threat, and you can compare the black and white pieces. You can see that all of black pieces are extremely active, and no one is active. White don't have any good piece. So bishop e4, he tried to exchange some pieces, and of course when we are in attack we don't like to exchange pieces, so I keep the piece on the board. Knight f1, knight h3, and the final mistake came here from black. He played this move, bishop g5. Can you find the best move here for white? Of course, a double attack, rook g2. Double attacks can win the game. So I hope you enjoy this lesson and start playing martial. All the best.